All right. First things first, you all are going to smile for me. I want to do a selfie, if that's okay. If not, oh well. You can sign a disclaimer or something later. All right, are you ready? 3, 2, 1. That way I can send it to my family and say, see, I really am a mayor, I swear. Anyhow, thank you so much for coming. It's great to see faces. I love it. It's absolutely wonderful. And thank you for those who are watching. Thank you, TVC TV, for posting this on Facebook for us live, which is awesome. And, you know, I'm just so grateful and honored that you all are here spending your time with me in North Plains, and it means a lot to me. Thank you. I will share the highlights of how we came together and connected as a community in 2021, and I will also share what we look like, what we look forward to as we move forward together in 2022. People often ask me how much I make as a mayor, and is it a full-time job? It's a full-time job, for sure, but they're also surprised when they hear that it is a volunteer gig. There are no perks. You are either called to volunteer or you're not. And volunteering is not for everyone, and that's okay. Volunteers are special people. If you serve on a committee in North Plains at this time, I would really like to recognize you. So please stand up and let's recognize our volunteers in North Plains. You notice that was like a third of the room. We also are grateful for our elected partners, and I want to just make mention of them, and I'm going to make you all stand up too. So if you're an elected official, please stand up and be recognized. All right, now you can get all situated again. Now that we got the blood flowing. The Chamber of Commerce and the North Plains Senior Center are wonderful partners to our community, and we're very gracious that they are hosting and supporting us this evening. Patty Burns and Holly Burns, thank you so much for putting together refreshments and food for us this evening. We really greatly appreciate you. Thank you so much. (Clears throat) 2021 was another year of unprecedented events and challenges, but it was also a year of achievements and bright spots. Many cities practice the art of goal setting, and recently the City Council refined our city goals. We take pride in community involvement, so we will up our game to recruit new residents to boards and committees. We will invest in the Urban Renewal District to create a vibrant downtown. And we will continue to support our growth potential while maintaining our small town charm. And we will balance the cost of services so the wants align with the needs. One of the biggest accomplishments is the Glencoe Opportunity Area. And I know there's a lot of talk about that area. This area is located on Glencoe Road, just a half a mile north of Highway 26. We made great progress on this site in 2021. In March, the city purchased the land. In June, an RFP for a developer was issued. And in November, the city entered into an exclusive negotiation agreement with a Portland-based woman-owned developer, Rembold, for key commercial services, including a full-service grocery store, hardware store, eateries, and a retail bike shop. Rembold has developed multiple mixed-use projects in other nearby communities and has been looking for development opportunities in North Plains. To quote Rembold Vice President Callie Bader, quote, "This exciting development is designed to celebrate inclusivity, local industries, fresh food and drink, and curated services that celebrate North Plains' history and future. Did you know that in 1912, passenger and freight trains stopped in North Plains 4 times a day? These trains would carry people, produce, animals, and timber. Today, we want a sustainable economic community that reflects our history and improves our livability. Realizing a local grocery store and shops will provide much needed jobs to the residents of North Plains. We look forward to working with the community and the Rembold team on this very important 5-acre development. Every city wants a vibrant downtown, and we are no different. We continued our work on the Downtown Improvement Plan. It's a project advisory committee representing both community members and businesses was formed to help guide the process with the help of consultants and a grant from the State of Oregon Department of Transportation and Land Conservation and Development. What a mouthful. We move forward with the planning to enhance livability and economic vitality in the downtown core. We greatly appreciate everyone who participated in our online open house and took an online survey. Staff and council are leveraging our resources to connect with the community to get their input to strengthen and enhance the downtown for many decades. A new community survey will be online April 4th, and an in-person open house is scheduled to take place downtown on April 12th. So mark your calendar, and I hope that you can join us. Another buzz around town is the Bryn Hill development. This development will bring over 500 homes to North Plains. An increase in housing can bring challenges to a community, as we all know. However, these rooftops are what attracts a grocery store and other retail options. Housing also supports our local businesses and aids in attracting a talented workforce for the local economy. Bryn Hill runs along North Avenue, which is a major corridor that will connect this new neighborhood to other parts of North Plains. As you've seen these last couple of months, North Avenue is receiving a makeover with expanded sidewalks, bike lanes, street trees, and a median. So for those in the audience who regularly schedule a tee time at your favorite golf course, be prepared for a slower commute on North Avenue and a change to the speed limit. I want to personally thank all of the affected residents for your patience. It's not fun, but the upgrades are pretty important on this collector. In 2021, the city continued its work on the Urban Growth Boundary Expansion Project. This is the area outside of the city limits, which is intended to ensure a 20-year supply of residential and employment needs. The land around North Plains is undesignated rural reserves. With the city's population expected to double by 2040, this is a critical project in managing our community's path forward. The fact is, North Plains is changing, and like others, we are running out of land. Through careful planning for expansion, North Plains will maintain community connections, livability, and a path to fiscal stability. We will also contribute to the success of the area's Silicon Forest. North Plains will expand the UGB to accommodate new homes and jobs in the region. In the fall of 2020, we initiated this multi-year UGB expansion project. The project advisory committee was convened to guide the process and make recommendations to the Planning Commission and City Council for consideration. In phase one, the city established a study area of approximately 1,700 acres to be considered. In phase two, now in progress, we are assessing the ability of each sub-area to meet the city's needs and eventually determine which land will be added to the UGB. We hope to submit these changes to the state by the end of the summer. The strategic planning involves hours of labor from staff, consultants, and volunteers. And I can't thank our local committee volunteers enough for the essential work you do to ensure we are doing the right thing. I want to acknowledge a specific community volunteer who has given 27 years of his time and sweat equity to ensure North Plains moves in the best direction it can and should. Stuart King. Where are you, Stuart? Stuart. Stuart, I understand the time commitment you put in to make sure that the vision for North Plains is on the right trajectory. We really appreciate your input and thank you for all you do for us. Infrastructure. The City Council adopted a capital improvement program in 2021 that guides our future system needs for streets, water, parks, and capital facilities. In late 2020, voters passed a local fuel tax of 3 cents per gallon that enabled the city to take out a transportation bond to help with vital infrastructure improvements. Immediately after the passage, the city finalized a plan for the transportation projects to be funded in part by this tax. These funds have helped with the pedestrian and intersection improvements along Glencoe and West Union Road. More projects are on the horizon for 2022, including the addition of sidewalks along the north section of Glencoe Road. The Cottage Street Overlay Project and the Water Main Replacement are two separate projects on the city's capital improvement project list. However, we combine them so they are a dig once approach. These projects are brought to you from the fuel tax. The North Plains Water Reservoir and Pump Station Number 2 is located on West Union Road. That is now completed. The new 2 million gallon above ground water storage tank and pump station has added capacity to the existing 1 million gallon reservoir on Commercial Street. The new facility will help bring water service to new homes and businesses, provide significant water flow for fire emergencies, and will increase water storage for daily use. This seismically resilient critical infrastructure will serve North Plains water needs well into the future. On that site, we hope to build a new public works and emergency operation facility as well. And planning will wrap up later this year, and we are hoping to begin construction in 2023. We look forward to working with our partners at Washington County and DLCD on addressing the traffic impacts on all of our roads, as well as more infrastructure projects to meet the growing demands of our community. Parks and trails. The West Union pedestrian path is now completed. And if you haven't walked it or seen it, you really have to try it. It's a gorgeous path. The path was a group effort. Thank you to the Hillsborough School District, Representative Susan McLean, Senator Janine Solman, and retired Senator Chuck Riley, who I see way in the back. Thank you for believing in our project and providing us with the additional funding to complete the safe path for our families. It's a great addition to our community because it provides a safe path for families to walk between our neighborhoods along a very busy county road. 14 years ago, I was part of the Walking Trail Committee. It was an ad hoc group. We envisioned a walking path that connected all the neighborhoods around the perimeter of North Plains. Well, today we are just one step closer of creating a safe and walkable city. Families would shy away from lengthy playdates here at Jessie May's because we didn't have a family-friendly restroom available for them to use. When you gotta go, you gotta go. Well, today we've got a place for them to go. Jessie May's restroom was finally completed. Additional upgrades to the park are being considered, and we hope to finalize these outdoor improvements later this year. Many of the progress in our parks area would not have been completed without the direction and dedication of our longtime employee, Blake Boyles. He's finally hanging up his yellow vest and work boots in June and is looking forward to retirement in sunny Arizona. Thank you, Blake, for your dedication to the improvements in the city, and we wish him nothing but the best in his retirement. On November 11, 2020, during a pandemic, and with a little help from our friends, we safely opened and dedicated the North Plains Veterans Park. Since then, the park has been awarded two awards, one from the Oregon American Public Works Association for Project of the Year, and the other from the American Council of Engineering Companies for Engineering Excellence. We realized this dream through the partnership and support from the community and the professionals and veterans at Kittleson & Associates, 3J Consulting, OTEC, Subcon, Excavation, and many local veterans who believed in doing the right thing was to honor our men and women in uniform. Every day we lose hundreds of World War II veterans. In just a few short years, most of these amazing heroes will have passed into history. Tonight, I want to briefly recognize the stories of four men who we honored this past year. In this picture here is Bob Jackson, Elmer Mays, and Carl Schmedeke. Bob and Carl passed away this year, and Elmer, who's 95, he's still with us. Bob Ganos. Bob Ganos was a veteran and a revered member of our community as well. By Bob, Carl, and Elmer's standards, Bob Ganos was a youngster at 75. Bob Jackson was 97, Carl 99, and of course Elmer was 95. Bob Jackson, he enlisted into the Navy in World War II and was deployed to the Pacific aboard an aircraft carrier, the USS Cowpens, as a radio, radar, aircraft technician. Carl Schmedeke, he passed in June. He was 32 days shy of his 100th birthday. He served in the U.S. Army as a private first class in the 84th Infantry Division as part of the rail splitters. He was captured from a pillbox with 11 others on the Siegfried Line on Thanksgiving Day in 1944. Carl's story is particularly interesting to me because my grandfather was in the same area during the same time and was lost after that attack. Carl returned in the U.S. in 1945, as did my grandfather. And while I have no idea if they knew each other, because my grandfather passed years ago, I would like to think maybe they did. Bob Ganos was drafted into the Army as a second lieutenant. He moved his family to Germany while he served, and when he returned to the States, he moved his family to North Plains and bought a farm where he grew garlic. He was very active in the American Legion Post 6 and was an integral part of the formation and naming of the Elephant Garlic Festival. Elmer is still with us. He's a descendant of Jessie Mays, who was a revered North Plains community member. Elmer enlisted in the U.S. Navy as an electrician's mate. He was stationed in the Pacific during World War II and served in the Korean campaign with great honors. I tell you these stories because these men and their families are part of the generational heart and soul of the North Plains community, and we honor them today. North Plains has two of the finest elementary schools in the Hillsborough School District, and we welcome two new principals this year, Danny Johnson at Folity Ridge, and Kelly Petrick at North Plains Elementary. In 2021, we were thrilled to officially open At Folity Ridge Elementary, located in the Sunset Ridge neighborhood. The At Folity name recognizes the At Folity people who inhabited the plains surrounding the Tualatin River and the hills near Forest Grove. North Plains Elementary also received some upgrades, a new gym, a student drop-off area, and a playground. It has been an especially tough few years for our educators, and we praise you for your perseverance and resiliency in continuing to offer a top-notch and safe education to our children. Early in 2021, we welcomed a new police chief, James Haxton. He, along with deputies Clarissa Conway and Stephen Schutz, continue to strengthen the community partnership for the safety of North Plains. North Plains has contracted police services with Washington County Sheriff's Office for 3 years now. We are thankful for the beneficial partnership with the Washington County Sheriff's Office, and this enables us to leverage support for cost-effective and high-quality services for safety and livability in our community. As we all know, the world of policing and public safety is evolving, and our community believes in and supports the need for law enforcement. In 2022, the City Council will discuss our service level needs with the Sheriff's Office, and we will plan for future funding to sustain our community safety services. We also value our partnership with the Tualatin Valley Fire and Rescue and their continued fire and emergency services and their response in North Plains. After the pandemic affected their outreach efforts and the community's efforts to visit with them, it is great to be able to connect with them again in person and again in our community. The city also adopted an emergency operations plan in 2021. This is required by state law and is an invaluable framework to guide the management of emergency situations. Our little engine that could is also known as the library. I think we got a couple of pictures there that might be a little sideways, but that's all right. Well, I'll tell you what, I love our little library. Who doesn't? Our library is staffed by a remarkable group of people who continue to serve as a valuable role in transforming the lives and strengthening our community. Robin and her team were incredibly creative, patient, and innovative in adapting and adding fantastic services for all ages, especially during the pandemic. Next week is National Library Week, so please stop by the library and take a selfie. As we celebrated its 15th anniversary, we faced continued operational challenges due to COVID. We operationalized a variety of procedures and improvements to keep people safe, including contact-free holds and pickups, shelf shopper, personalized recommendations of books. I've done that and it's awesome. Movies and podcasts, and our public works crew built a special library outpost in the Sunset Ridge neighborhood to simplify sharing books in the community. It's this picture in the bottom left. Staff also provided a variety of online programs, such as the weekly support class for 5 and 6 year olds, and they had kindergarten readiness classes online. These classes are so important in helping COVID affected children catch up. We provided outdoor picnic tables by the library entrance for safety, internet hotspots for checkout, and extended Wi-Fi service. Many of these were made possible in part by grants from the Institute of Museum and Library Services through the Library Services and Technology Act and ARPA funds. Our library continues to take pride in the service it provides to all members who patronize it. We have had a total of 62,466 checkouts, and we set a record for electronic checkouts of 14,514. While these numbers don't compare to the pre-pandemic levels, we are very proud of the little library that keeps on doing. In 2022, the library will embark on a new strategic plan, and the summer reading program begins on June 1st. This year, the theme for the reading program is Read Beyond the Beaten Path. The library will also have a youth survival class series and is bringing back the popular picnic bingo. Communications. The city continues a proactive and strategic communications plan by utilizing many tools to communicate and engage with the community on a wide range of initiatives and projects, as well as working to promote community events and other ways to keep our community as connected as possible while staying safe. We created the volunteer spotlights to recognize many of our wonderful community volunteers. It's like the who's who of the community. We created the monthly City 101 feature in the newsletter. This feature helps shed light on how the city works, the city services, initiatives, such as the emergency preparedness. Where does your water come from and where does it go? It's very informational, and many, many constituents have really praised that piece of that feature. And I want to thank our communications consultant, Corinne Weiss, for her invaluable creativity and energy for bringing our communication plan forward in a positive and meaningful way. During the pandemic, the North Plains Events Association and its volunteers wanted to keep the community spirit growing by offering safe community events. We did a pretty good job at delivering, I think, and we're pretty proud of our community events in North Plains. I think we know how to party. And this past year, it was so nice to see so many of you at the Garlic Festival and the annual Christmas tree lighting. At this time, I wanted to introduce Cindy Smith. She's the volunteer coordinator and the North Plains Events Association board member. And I want her to just come up and say a few words of a preview for the events in 2022.
Good evening. It's very nice to be here. When I first moved into North Plains, I was just really amazed at all of the activities that were going on all the time. And it's a small community, but I came from a small community growing up, and it's just a very vibrant place to live. And so I had to get involved. So as you mentioned, the things that we did last year, but coming up this year, we don't have to modify anything so far, it looks like. And we're all ready to go. In fact, April 16th is our first event with the Community Egg Hunt for children 10 and under. And it's at the North Plains Elementary School at 10 a.m. And we're doing that in conjunction with 12 Fire and Rescue. So we're really excited to get started. On April 21st, right here in Jessie May's Community Center, we're having our spaghetti dinner and volunteer recognition night. It starts at 6:30, and last year we had to modify and we kind of did a little takeout, but this year we're going to be inside and seated. So we're very excited to be moving on. All right. Of course, in May, we have our annual garage sale day. We frequently have many families sign up to participate in that. And the week after, we have our annual cleanup day. Last year, we tried a few new things, tried a new location, and did a little different advertising, and it was a huge success. We really want to thank Garbarino's, of course, St. Edward Church for the use of their land and parking lot. And of course, McDonald's is always a great supporter for that event for us. In June, you get to come rub shoulders with your city council members because they dish up the ice cream at our ice cream social every year. Last year, we modified a little bit, so we just handed out ice cream bars, but this year it's back to the bowls and as many scoops as you want, almost. We work them out. Okay, and shortly after that, we have a fairly new event that we got to do once and then modified, and then we're gonna do it up again this year, is our Strawberry Shortcake Feast. So that's the Saturday before Father's Day. So that's a good summer event. If you want something to do on a Saturday, come join us. And of course, Garlic Festival, our big event. This year it's number 24. And again, it's the second weekend in August. And you might want to come because Stinky has a new surprise for us this year. And I'm not going to say any more. Stinky's our mascot. Okay? That's him up there on the poster. All right, October, chili cook-off. This one we haven't done in 2 years, but we're going to do it this year. We're really excited. November is our Christmas bazaar. We hold it at North Plains Elementary, and so we're looking forward to having that again. That's also been on hold. December is our big windup, is Jingle through North Plains. That's our lighted parade. And last year, we had the best one, the biggest turnout we've had ever. And we're just really excited to go for it again and to enjoy it. And I welcome any of you who want to get involved too, to let me know, because I'm volunteer coordinator. I'll be happy to sign you up. So, thank you.
Thank you, Cindy. We do know how to party here. Just saying. Fiscal stability. I'm pretty proud of our approach to fiscal stability. We know that responsible and healthy city finances are critical for a community to prosper. We want North Plains on a solid and sustainable financial footing for many years to come so that we can provide exceptional services to all of our residents and businesses. So I know financial details can be a little dry, but I can't help but highlight just a few of the positive examples. In 2021, the city moved from an annual budget to a biennial budget. A 5-year capital improvement program was adopted, dedicating revenues and expenses for long-term investments in city facilities and infrastructure. Even with the pandemic, the city received an S&P AA rating. It's a strong rating for a community of our size, and the S&P noted that our financial outlook is stable. The American Rescue Plan Act provided some needed fiscal relief to the city in 2021 so that we could make some overdue improvements on our city infrastructure that benefits the entire community. We were fortunate to receive $6.8 million from the state legislature to improve community infrastructure. $1.8 million from the ARPA funds. These funds came from the legislators, and we received to spread, the legislators received to spread among their district constituents. Of that, half of that money went to the West Union Pedestrian Path Project, and the other half will help with the Jessie Mays Park update. $5 million in lottery bond funding will go towards the new Public Works and Emergency Operations Center facility, and that is planned to increase the capacity and efficiency of these city services in response to our growing community. Despite the positive outlook, our community is growing and costs are increasing. We greatly value our partnerships with and support from Washington County, local and state electeds, and many others to help with funding for critical community projects and infrastructure. 15 years ago, we were flying under the radar of change. Today, we're steering the ship and making exciting things happening in North Plains. In 2022, again, we will complete the downtown improvement plan and be able to begin planning for positive changes. We will realize our plans for the Glencoe Opportunity Area for a grocery store, hardware store, and other commercial and retail businesses. We will identify the next UGB expansion areas. We will receive another tranche of ARPA funds to use towards more community projects and events. And we will continue to implement the city's capital improvement plan for important investments in city facilities and infrastructure. As we learn to live with the new endemic COVID, we look forward to many meaningful and in-person events. For the last couple of years, how many times have we said we're all in this together? A lot. Well, it's true, we are. We rely on ourselves and our partnerships to get us through good, the bad, and the ugly. None of us were expecting a pandemic to shut us down. We lost family and friends and loved ones. The pandemic affected all of our lives in so many different ways. But one thing I know to be true, The residents of North Plains remained steadfast. We didn't give up. No matter what life threw at us these last couple of years, we became more resilient as time went on. During the pandemic, community leaders such as myself tended to put the needs of others before ourselves. It's natural. I think in many ways, many of you in the room who volunteer or work in elected position, you tend to put others before your own needs. So as we move forward together in 2022, I want to remind you to take care of yourselves. I want to share a few lines from my favorite poem that kept me going during the pandemic and will keep me going forever. It's called Desiderata, A Way of Life by Max Ehrman. Mr. Ehrman was from Terre Haute, Indiana, a favorite town of mine. He was a lawyer and a poet, and this is one of his most famous pieces of work. His poem is inspiring. It reminds us to treat others kindly, accept people for who they are, and most importantly, to be kind to yourself. Quote, whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you conceive God to be. And whatever your labors and aspirations in the noisy confusion of life, keep peace in your soul. With all its shame, drudgery, and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be cheerful and strive to be happy. Thank you for coming, and God bless you all.